Chaya and Utsav are very good friends. Chaya is only a few months older than Utsav, but she is very bright in studies. And both are students of 6th grade. Chaya feels pleasure in studying and playing with Utsav, as he holds an inquisitive nature. Yesterday, both of them visited a fair with their families. Utsav was very upset after returning from the fair. He didn't take much interest in playing as well.
Utsav, why are you upset?
There were so many wonderful toys in the fair. That big colorful kite, that car, and that train was the best among them. I really wanted to purchase those toys, but they were so expensive.
There is no need to be disappointed.
Are you going to buy me those toys?
From where I would get so much money? But yes, collectively, both of us could have enough money to make a wonderful toy by ourselves. Come with me.
Utsav got surprised, but excited. Chaya purchased some decorative items, pencil, and a lot of ring and bar magnets from the nearby shop.
Chaya, what are we going to make from these things and what is the use of these magnets?
These will play the main role. Tell me, what do you know about these magnets?
I know that magnets are rocks which attract some metals like iron towards them.
And what else? Did you forget that we have just learned a chapter on magnets in our class a few days ago?
Yes, I do remember that. The endpoints of magnets are known as poles. Like magnetic poles repel each other. And unlike poles attract each other. Just like a few metals which get attracted towards magnets.
Absolutely correct. The materials which get attracted to magnets are known as magnetic materials, whereas the ones which do not get attracted to magnets are known as non-magnetic materials.
Yes, substances like soil, wood, our clothes, paper, and plastics do not get attracted to magnets. Hence, it means that these are non-magnetic objects.
Okay, have we not learned that the metals like nickel, cobalt and iron which get attracted by magnets can be transformed into magnets by us? Recall the experiments which our teacher has practically shown to us.
Yes, I do remember. Our teacher has taught us how to rub the magnets in sand and play with iron fillings when iron fillings in the sand adheres to the magnet. She also taught us how to find out directions from magnets.
Okay, if you remember, then explain me how to find directions from magnets.
It is very easy. See, we will tie a bar magnet with a thread and let it hang freely. This is evening time. The sun is in the west direction. And if we stand facing the west direction, then the north direction is in our right side. Now let's color the northern tip of the bar magnet as red. Now if we turn magnet a few times and leave it free again, we will see that the tip with red color would always stop in the north direction. We can try it again and again. It will always stop in the north direction. This is how we can find directions with the help of magnets.
Well done. But Utsav, you should always remember that while doing this, there should not be any other magnet beside the bar magnet. Otherwise, it will get attracted towards the other magnet and will turn in a different direction.
Good, thanks for reminding me.
Utsav, now we would use these properties of magnets to make a splendid toy for us. Now, we are going to make a kite which we will fly with the help of these magnets. For this, we need to use two spokes of a bicycle wheel colored paper, a long stick and a kite thread. I will make a kite with bicycle wheel, spokes and paper. Till then you...
And till then, I will find a long stick and attach this huge magnet on it with the help of a huge tape, right?
Absolutely correct. Let's tie the kite with this kite thread. Then we will have to tie the thread to some stationary object.
Wait, for that I will jab a pile in the land.
Now I am tying this kite to the pile. Take the stick with the magnet in your hand.
Look, this kite is getting attracted towards the stick. See Chaya, it is flying on lifting the stick up. Wow, I can fly it here and there as per my will. It's great experience.
Yes, Utsav. It is quite fun. The spokes in these kites are getting attracted towards the magnet. As the thread is tied to the pile, the kite is unable to reach the stick, but is continuously getting attracted and seems like it is flying. Due to the attraction between the magnet and kite, you can fly it with joy.
It's very nice. We will show it to everyone in the school.
Yes, yes, why not? Of course, we will show, but keep the magnets with care so that they don't lose their properties.
How would I do that?
Don't place the magnets in a hot place, as they lose their properties when they are heated. And they can also lose their properties after falling from a good height or on being struck by a solid object.
Okay.
We will take it to school tomorrow.
Of course, it will be fun. It is even better than the toys of the fair. Thank you, Chaya.